Today, it's incredibly exciting to see almost 250 wolves on the landscape, see huge numbers of pups being born in the wild, and to see increasing acceptance of wolves on the landscapes beyond just the federal government and beyond just the tribes, increasingly in the states and the private sector, to see wolves being accepted as other wildlife are on the landscape is incredibly rewarding and important for society, but we shouldn't be satisfied with the progress to date. We still have a lot of work to do.
So for the next 25 years, we hope to see population growth of the Mexican gray wolf in its current range. We also hope to see its genetic condition improve. Right now, the Mexican gray wolf numbers are so small and their genetics are so narrow that they're essentially related like brothers and sisters. So we need to introduce more valuable genetic diversity into the current population.
So I started out as a field technician with the volunteer project with Defenders of Wildlife. A lot of that entailed doing trail camera work, looking for oncollards, doing food caches, and pretty much boots on the ground work for the Mexican Wolf Recovery Project. We radio collar our wolves. This helps us keep track of where the wolves are. They do give us GPS locations, so we are able to look on a map and see where exactly they're at. This helps us get our counts on the Mexican wolf population. This helps us be able to manage them properly, especially around cattle and proactive management. And this allows us to do things like puppy fostering and knowing where dens are, which is all critically important for managing wolves.
Cross-fostering has been successful for Mexican gray wolves, and that's placing pups that are 10 days old or younger, and they're born in captivity, have high genetic value, and we'll place them into a wild wolf den to be raised by wild wolves. Other techniques that we use are trail cameras to get video or photos of certain individuals or to get counts on certain packs.
I'm a U.S. Fish and Wildlife volunteer sponsored by Defenders of Wildlife on the Mexican Wolf Project for the winter of 2022 going into 2023. With the game cameras, the main goal that I had with those was trying to get counts on the packs, trying to figure out how many animals are in each pack. And we use that data to come up with an end-of-year report. And that really helps us assess the strength of the population and the trend, whether it's growing or declining.
For the Mexican gray wolf to fully recover, what needs to happen next is we need to use the full force of the Endangered Species Act. And to do that, the Fish and Wildlife Service needs to manage this recovering population by the science, not by the politics. And we need to reintroduce more wolves from the captive population into the wild population. And we need to lift the boundaries so those wolves that are on the land now have the freedom to roam north. And when they wander north, they can meet up with the northern gray wolves coming down from the northern Rockies population. And that way, there'll be wolves distributed from Canada all the way to Mexico.
My hope for the Mexican gray wolf future is that they become a recovered species and we can take them off the endangered species list.
As far as where I want to see the Mexican wolf, I want to see him fully recovered by the time I'm done with the project. To be there, to hear that they're delisted, is where I want to be within the next 10 years or so.
My hope for Mexican wolves in the future is that they're able to move freely across the landscape. But at the end of the day, you know, my greatest hope is that we get to the point where we can allow wolves to be wolves and take advantage of all they offer us.